250 miles from the Nigerian capital of Abuja sits the sprawling city of Kano. It is the epicenter of Boko Haram's holy war against the country.
I really would prefer not to talk about Boko Haram's activities. They just make me very uncomfortable.
Is that because you're afraid?
Of course, everybody's afraid. We are all living in fear.
What this group is doing to our country is terrible. They are killing our people and they want to divide us.
Boko Haram's official name in Arabic means the people committed to propagation of the Prophet's teachings and jihad.
This is a faceless enemy. They don't wear uniform. They live among us and suddenly attack.
A spokesman for the Islamist group says the deadly attacks won't stop until Sharia law rules the country.
Boko Haram is a jihadist movement that has the same ideology as all other Salafi jihadists, as Al-Qaeda, as the Taliban, as Al-Shabaab. What they want to do is to establish an emirate, an Islamist radical state, first at the northern part of Nigeria, and then push to the south and declare an emirate across Nigeria.
It won't be easy. Nigeria is evenly split between Christians in the south and Muslims in the north. Sharia law is already in place across 12 states in the Muslim-majority north, and while Boko Haram wants to see the Islamic laws more strictly enforced, the group's radical theology has little traction in the south.
So now the group is trying to spark a religious war by getting Muslims and Christians to fight one another.
Founded in 2002, Boko Haram has terrorized Nigerian Christians by attacking their homes, churches, and killing scores of believers. Bishop Ransom Bello is a prominent Christian leader in Kano. He's received several death threats from radical Muslims. The most recent came from Boko Haram, warning about an impending attack against churches here.
I think my biggest worry is about the security of the Christians in Kano State.
At one of Kano's largest mosques, Imam Abu Bakr Jibrin used a recent Friday noon gathering to urge followers to remain calm and seek peace. But in an interview with CBN News following Friday prayers, Imam Jibrin refused to directly criticize or condemn the actions by Boko Haram. The group has distributed leaflets warning anyone, including Muslims, not to criticize their actions.
I don't know who these people are, so I can't judge them. I can't tell you if Boko Haram is a Muslim group or not.
Boko Haram has killed more than 1,000 people in some 160 separate attacks since July 2009. Many of the recent attacks were far more complex and coordinated than anything linked to Boko Haram before.
The bombs are increasingly sophisticated and powerful. So this has gone beyond a sort of local, radical group.
That has Nigerian and Western security officials worrying about potential links to international terrorist groups like Al-Qaeda. A Nigerian newspaper investigation traced funding for the group's activities to the UK and Saudi Arabia, and further plans to turn Nigeria into another Afghanistan. Members have also reportedly met and received training from senior Al-Qaeda figures in North Africa. And now, perhaps equally worrying, are reports of Boko Haram sympathizers within Nigeria's police, intelligence services, army, and judiciary, leaving many to worry about the future of Africa's most populous country.
I see this as a spiritual battle over Nigeria. Because these issues go beyond economic, goes beyond politics, goes beyond natural things. It's spiritual.
George Thomas, CBN News, Kano, Nigeria.